Hello, my name is Eric Brandsberg, CTO of Heimdall Data. Today we will demonstrate the installation of Heimdall into an existing WordPress environment hosted on AWS and using the Aurora database engine. Once installed, we will then demonstrate several features of Heimdall in separate videos, including caching and security. If you are following along with this video, please make sure that you have a functional WordPress installation already configured using an external database, and that you know where the database configuration is in WordPress. Before we begin installing the Heimdall server, we want to first create a security group that our instances will all share. I have already created a security group for this purpose, which allows ports 22 for Secure Shell, 80 for HTTP, 3306 for Aurora, and 8087 for the Heimdall Management Console. Next, we will want to install the Heimdall Management Console, which we will do using our community AMI. You can find the newest available AMI by clicking on the Launch Instance button, selecting Community AMIs, and search for Heimdall while in the Northern Virginia region. You will then select the T2 medium instance, as the central manager doesn't require a large instance to run, but we will want more than one core for background log processing. Finally, we will select the security group configured previously and start the instance, which will take a few minutes. Once started, the Heimdall instance can be accessed via port 8087 on the instance's public IP. The default user account will be admin, and the default password will be the instance ID of the AWS instance. Once logged in, we will navigate to the Virtual Database tab, where you will find that a WordPress template configuration has been provided. The important points to note here are first, that the access mode selected is MySQL proxy, and in the proxy settings, the proxy port is set to 5050. Next, note that the proxy authentication option is enabled, and authentication is set to the username WordPress user and password of htpassword. These are the credentials that the application will use to connect to the proxy once installed on the application server. Finally, we note that caching is enabled and set to Hazelcast. If an alternate caching provider is desired, this can be adjusted later. Next, we will want to navigate to the Data Sources tab. Here, the database access is configured. Again, a WordPress sample is provided that we can use for this install. For this configuration, you will want to copy in the existing settings from your WordPress install into the appropriate fields, including the host name and port, the username, password, and database instance name. Verify that the configuration is correct using the Test Source button. The rest of the source settings that provide compatibility for WordPress can be found in the Connection Properties dropdown. As WordPress does not provide connection pooling, we have this feature enabled as well to reduce the overhead of establishing connections to the database server on each page view. Once the data source is configured and tested, make sure that the virtual database configuration points to the data source to verify the basic configuration is complete. From here, we can install the proxy component into the WordPress server image. In order to simplify the process of installing the Heimdall proxy into an Ubuntu Linux image, I've created a script that can be used and posted it on our download site, which can be retrieved with curl or wget as shown. Once downloaded, edit the script with the appropriate account and Heimdall manager information from the proxy settings. Please note, We are using the proxy authentication credentials in place of Heimdall access control authentication, as these credentials are automatically available as a read-only user to the API layer for simplified configuration. For a production install, it is suggested that you modify the credentials from the default supplied. Next, make the script executable and execute to install the proxy. Please review the script for a deeper understanding of how the proxy is set up and execute it as a background task. To verify that the proxy is executing, simply use the ps command and grep for Heimdall as shown. Now that the proxy is running in our WordPress server, we can configure WordPress to use the proxy to access the database. In the wp-config.php file, simply change the database configuration variables to account for the database name, user, password, and host. These will use the proxy authentication credentials, and in this case will point to port 5050 on localhost. Once saved, these settings will immediately be used by WordPress, and the activity can be observed on the Heimdall console dashboard. At this point, we have completed the basic configuration of Heimdall with WordPress.